In this video, we're going to talk about shining a face scanner and IOS scanner. And I'm Alan Banks with ROE Dental Lab, and I'm sitting here with Dr. Isaac Tawil. And they have several different components that they're offering the clinical office. But one of the two key ones that we like to say is part of our digital levels is the IOS scanner, which most offices have now, but almost nobody has a face scanner. And so if you're thinking of buying a face scanner, this we're going to talk about why this one is so good, but you can buy, you can use a face scanner really at any of our different levels. What is so different about the shining IOS and face scanner that would separate them from doing an a la carte, which is pretty much what you have to do anybody else? What is unique about those two together?
So let's talk about the intraoral scanner first. The technology built into the intraoral scanner is actually really tremendous. It's one of the fastest scanners I've ever used, the most accurate out of some of the ones that I've used. And I have,
you have 12
intraoral scanners in my office. It's really incredibly accurate. We have the ability to capture those hard-to-reach areas. One example would be contact points. We're trying to capture around an implant or around a tooth. You want to capture the interproximal areas, and this just picks it up with ease, with amazing accuracy. The other part is the AI technology. So in turn, when we're capturing the tongue or the lips or the cheeks involved when we're scanning, this just wipes it right out, which is really fantastic for something that's affordable scanning.
Right.
Usually you don't see those unless they're on the more expensive end of the intraoral scanner. So having the Wi-Fi technology, the Wi-Fi 6 technology, so we do not have to have line of sight with the scanner. The modular base could be behind the wall, and you can still scan.
It comes in wired and wireless.
Yeah, there's two options. So there's a wireless or wired option. Obviously, one's a little bit more expensive. For another, I think, $2,000, you can buy the wireless, which is still very, very affordable. And it's the shocking part is the affordability with the amazing technology that they are offering. Usually, you won't see those together.
So I scanned everything I could, everything dental I put in my hand, I could scan with that wand.
Absolutely.
I thought it was incredible.
Absolutely.
360 scans of just about everything you want, which is what we do,
You
know, every day.
Yep. We have lots of different technology that we want to pick up. For example, iJigs and OptiSplints that we want to capture a lot of data from. And you want the ability to have tracking easily. So if we go move to one part and realize we got to pick up something else from the other side, this thing just picks it right back up. Mm. It does not take long. The other nice part is the different scanning tips. You have a larger tip and a smaller tip that you can get to those hard to reach areas. Mm. So if we're doing a second molar prep, or if you're doing a pterygoid implant and you can't get the patient open wide, you swap out the tip mid scan, you can stop, pop on the smaller tip and capture those hard to reach areas.
So the IOS is really impressive.
And one other feature, which is very, very important, especially for implants, which is the depth of field. You got 22 millimeters of depth of field.
Oh, that's really far.
That is very deep. We can actually pick up the internal aspects of the implants when we're capturing. So if we're looking to capture those sulcuses, those emergence profiles, we capture them with ease using the intraoral scanner.
Huh. That would help with intraoral, with undercuts for preps, like you said, but then also with scanning full arch prosthetics in your finger outside.
Absolutely.
Your hand, right? So you're not just scanning one little part, you're scanning
the entire.
That's impressive.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So then you have the IOS, but then you've got this magical face scanner.
It's a revolutionary product, partly because of the fact that anything that was revolutionary with facial scanning was so expensive that we came out of the realm to be able to purchase in a more traditional dental office. If you run a very large practice where you have multiple doctors and utilizing a face scanner on a daily basis, then you might want to say, okay, I would have spent the money on a very expensive facial scanner. Now we have the best technology in the most affordable range. Yeah. And the better part of it is the technology is as good, if not better, than any other facial scanner that I've used in my practice. When we're looking at a facial scanner, we want a couple of things.
Yeah.
We want to be able to have that no strobe light effect where we can actually keep the patient's eyes open so we can do before and after scans, and we can actually do patient matching instead of having to put fiducial markers on the patient's face. The other important aspect is we want to try to capture the teeth, and many facial scanners fall far short of being able to capture teeth. And that becomes the hardest part, is doing that matching. If you want to do manual matching of an intraoral scan to your actual facial scan, it becomes quite hard if the teeth are distorted in any way. So you can see here, we're capturing a post-op of a patient, and you can see the accuracy of capturing each tooth, every incisal edge, the bite position, everything is on mark. So if we want to go ahead and see what a design would look like, we're able to capture that. Here's his initial scan, and we made some massive changes on this patient, changing a 4-millimeter plane of occlusion, lowering it down. We were able to do that by utilizing this fantastic MetiSmile facial scanner.
Did you mention the facial hair?
Ah, even with facial hair. So even a person like me that has all these stubble and all these little hairs, we can capture with tremendous depth. It's actually quite impressive. There is nothing that can stop this MetiSmile. It's a small package too. It's not a big thing that you have to find a room for in your office. You have different options. You can hold it with your hand and scroll around the patient and capture the face itself, or you can have the patient sit down and just have them turn their head, or you can just put them in a chair and rotate the patient side to side to capture it. And there is nothing that stops this facial scanner. Hair, makeup, whatever it may be, it picks it up with extreme accuracy, which is the most important part of having the facial scan, because what's the point of a facial scan if we can't actually utilize it in our digital workflow?
Yeah, and so I think one of the key features is the facial hair. We mentioned it, but at least half of the male full arch patients that come through the laboratory have either a goatee or they have a full beard, and all the other facial scanners leave this almost completely blank. It's hollow. So all you have maybe is some tissue around the lips, but usually they're covering their teeth with hair too, because they just want to cover up their smile.
Yep.
And the other scanners won't pick it up. And the other is just the detail of it. I mean, you saw that scan, the detail of it, the ability to match the teeth, which is the other thing.
The auto-matching. Auto-matching is incredible. If you're using the intraoral scan from Shiny 3D, the Aoralscan3, you can have an auto-merge that's just instantaneous, which is a wonderful feature to have. But even if you're not, you can still do point matching. Sometimes there's some cases that are beyond the computer. It happens once in a blue moon. The key is, can you do that matching? Yeah. And this software does the matching with ease. So by the time it gets to the laboratory, the technician does not have to do any of that work. It's already done for them, packaged together, and they're already on to designing instead of trying to find the right match between the actual file of the facial scan and the intraoral scan.
Yeah, it's a problem. If the face scan is not accurate and detailed, then we have a face scan, we have teeth, and we need to get the jaw. And that is incredibly hard if we can't do points exactly where all the anatomy is. It just won't, we'll have something close, but it won't be perfect. And you really gotta have perfect when you're working with incisal edge position and plane of occlusion. You scan the IOS, you scan the face, it puts them together and you hit send. So, you know, imagine, because this scanner is so accurate, you scan a denture 360, and then you scan the opposing, put the denture back in, scan the bite, take a face scan, smiling, it'll put those two things together, and we can make a beautiful either new full arch or a denture case, and we can make it based on the patient's soft tissue and the hard tissue or the denture, and we can do it with much more accuracy than something you can actually be proud of to show the patient, as opposed to, you know, just some models on the screen or on the articulator. I mean, the patient can really have some buy-in of what they're getting for their money.
Absolutely. And the ultimate goal is to reduce the amount of treatment time. So having the facial scanner combined with the intraoral scan, very often we skip the printed triangle straight to final because we know that the design is going to match because we have the patient's face in three dimensions.
Right.
It's not a 2D photo, it's a three-dimensional capture. So we do that already when we're dealing with teeth, when we're trying to just do a three-unit bridge, but can we do it with full arch? Yes, we can do it with full arch.
Totally.
The facial scanner gives us the ability to look at the design and be able to deliver what the design is actually created.
Because we know today with either grammetry or photogrammetry and these just brilliant IOS scans, we know we have the bite, the teeth, the articulation, we have that all set. It's the aesthetics that we have to have the patient sign off on.
Correct.
Right? They don't care about the rest of
it. No, they want to look and see their smile.
Yeah.
And if you do all that work and you skip the printed try-in phase and go straight to final without a facial scanner, you have no idea where that incisal edge position is going to be at.
Roll the dice.
And you don't know exactly where that midline is going to be at. We don't know if there's going to be any canting, but now we do. Now with the facial scanner, we can capture all of that with the intraoral scanner, combine the two together, make our design, and be able to deliver what we're actually designing.
And that's the simplest package. Well, iOS you can buy by itself, but a package, iOS, and a face scanner. And then you can go to our website, which is rodentallab.com/shining or shining3D. And in there, you can see those two, but then you can also see the bundles, because the package can also have a printer, a curing unit, a cleaning unit, and even one of really a world-class
desktop scanner.
Desktop scanner.
Yeah, absolutely.
3 to 5 microns for some of this full arch work that we do.
Mm-hmm. So, which is wonderful for our eye jigs and opti splints when we want to capture them, instead of having to use an intraoral scanner.
Yeah.
In just seconds we capture, or even for a denture duplicate.
Sure.
Or a model scan.
Yeah.
You don't have to save those files anymore. You don't have to save those models anymore. We can save the files instead of the models, and have them in the cloud instead of worrying about, you know, our models disappearing or anything like that. If you're happy with your finals and you want to save a copy of that, we can save that together. I make patient folders, and I save the patient folders, have it backed up, and we're good to go. Anything ever happens down the road, we have all the ability to reprint, remill, anything we want to do in the digital realm.
There is so much non-information about face scanners out there on the market, because they think of it as a luxury item, or
right.
what did you call it?
A novelty.
A novelty, yeah. But it's not really a novelty. It's just not common enough, and that's unfortunate. So thank you for that. And as always, follow us on social media, Facebook, Instagram. We have a very robust YouTube channel. We're kind of an open book. And then, of course, you can visit us on our website, rodentallab.com/shining, to learn about all these things we learned about just here with their packages. And the top right corner of every page is our social media links.